Okay guys, so this is the ultimate flashcard combination. Once you've got this set up, you'll have flashcards on your PC, on your phone, and they'll all be synchronized together, which means whatever you do on one will be reflected on the other. It's also got a built-in spaced repetition system, which is the thing that Pleco really lacks by itself. Most Chinese learners I know will use Pleco or know of it, but still the spaced repetition system isn't as good as Anki. So let's show you how to properly get Anki and Pleco working together as a team, and to have your phone and another device like a laptop or a computer synced perfectly together. So here on the Anki website, we'll just go ahead and download whatever we need first. Make sure you get it for the right operating system. There's phone and Android over here. The next thing we need to download is Pleco. Pleco is downloadable from any normal app store. And then once we're inside it, we need to navigate to the add-ons section. Here we need to download the flashcards bundle. It will usually be in this available tab, but because I've already installed it, it's over in the installed section for me. Open up Ankidroid. This is what it looks like. We have to open Ankidroid first, because there's a kind of a bug inside Pleco when you swap the systems over, which is what we're going to do now. So if you come up to the Pleco menu, the first thing we need to do is back up any existing flashcards inside Pleco, because once you migrate the system over to Anki, you want to make sure that all that data is saved and backed up, because you won't be able to use it when you're inside Anki. So we're just going to navigate to the menu again and hit export. The default settings are fine, Pleco will recognize this if you ever need to re-import them. So we'll just export it, I'm going to stick it in the downloads folder, and you can put it in a safe place on the cloud or on your desktop. And this time we're going to go into the settings. Scroll right the way down and you'll find flashcards. This is the interesting part that turns Pleco into so much more. Click on flashcard system and you'll see that we can swap from Pleco to Ankidroid. This is where you need Ankidroid open in the background, otherwise it's going to bug out. I've set some of these settings before, but you'll have to go through and set them yourself manually. We'll change default card model to basic, and also the default new card model for a close to close. And now we want to configure the card models. This is the process in which Pleco turns its dictionary into flashcards for Anki. So first of all, we'll just go ahead and check basic, because that's really all you need. You see there's two sides, there's the front and the back. The front is the part that you see first, before the definition or whatever is revealed. And the back is the part that's revealed. So you can customize these to make them whatever you want, but I just like to keep it as basic as possible. You want to make sure that it is checking for word duplicates, so you don't end up with duplicate cards that you're repeating unnecessarily. If we go into the front then, I only want the simplified headword. If you're learning traditional, maybe you can stick that in. Or if you're testing something else, for example, if you're testing your writing, you could just stick in the pronunciation. And then that way you can use the pinyin to practice your writing skills. And then if we go to the back, we're going to want the traditional as well. We're going to want the pronunciation, so that's the pinyin. And we're also going to want the definition, so I'm going to click that. This is going to give us everything we need when we reveal the flashcard. The default setting for the Mandarin system, which is how it's going to display your syllables phonetically, is none, which isn't very helpful. So I'm just going to change that to pinyin, which I use. If you use Julian, or you prefer to see the pinyin with the numbers, then yeah, there's your options. This is just a formatting thing. I also just don't want it to change the pinyin formatting. And finally, we'll click to include examples. Okay, so now we are fully set up and ready to bring some cards into Ankidroid. If you're going to be using Anki on desktop as well, then you also want to set that up. So the little kind of refresh button at the top right, that's going to allow you to create an account or to log in. Once you're logged in, it will sync automatically if you turn that setting on, or you can just hit the button to synchronize yourself. Over on the desktop, I just want to show you how that works as well. So you can click that sync button to sign in, and then afterwards, click it again to synchronize between your phone and your desktop versions of the flashcards. The main reason you're synchronizing is because every time you review the flashcards, it's going to update the whole database system that is working on your personal learning. So synchronizing these between sessions is really important. If you move from your phone to your desktop and then you start working on your desktop, you're going to lose the progress on your phone. Or if you add words to your phone after you've had a session of flashcards on your desktop and you forgot to save your desktop, then you're going to lose your progress on one or the other. So getting into the habit of syncing as you get into the program and as you get off is going to save you a lot of unnecessary hassle. Okay, so now I'm going to get into actually adding these flashcards into Ankidroid. We're going to rename the default deck into self-study, and I'm going to create a couple of other decks just so we can see how it's working. We'll call this Week of Chinese, and I'm just going to call this Writing, just to remind you that you can use this in other ways. Back over in Pleco, let's add our first flashcard. Let's go for a Shuyan, an experiment. To now add it, if I hold down the plus icon, it's going to give me some options. For me, a lot of these default options are going to work well, but I'll just go into them quickly to show you how it works. You can see we've got the basic setting, which is the model we've set up, and we've got our three decks here, which is brought in from Anki. You can see they totally integrate with each other. So that's it. We can go ahead and add that card. And if we just add one of my favorite Chungyus to this as well, this time I'm just going to click the plus without holding it down. This will add this flashcard based on the last settings that we used. Over in Ankidroid, you can see they are immediately brought in. So this is where the magic happens. This is the flashcard. We've got Shuyan here. And if we reveal it, we can see that it is indeed Shuyan. And here, Ma Dao Chonggong. And I'm going to sync it because I'm now leaving the program. I want to check this is all working on my desktop. So we'll come over to the desktop and sync that up again. And there they are, the three decks. And it's saying we've got zero in self-study because we've just studied that. So just to prove that it's working, we can come in and we can add another Chungyu. This is one that Ella recently taught me. It was on our idioms podcast on our Patreon. Which is basically saying you can overcome many things if you're thorough, hardworking, diligent. Which is apt here, I think, for flashcard learning because you can just keep at it, keep working hard, and you will eventually learn every word that you stick into your flashcard system. That's just how it works. That's just how us humans work. And I'm going to swap it up. I'm going to add it to writing this time. Back over in Ankidroid, it's right there in writing. And I'm going to sync this up so we can see it take place on the desktop version. And here you go. We can study it on the desktop version if we want it instead. 勤能补拙. Congratulations. And we can go in and see our daily progress if we want to. Right now we're looking inside the writing deck. So it's going to show stats specifically for the writing deck. If we come over to the phone, I also want to show you that it works inside the phone too. This is a cool way just to like give you some motivation and see some real progress. And there's lots of different cool funky graphs that you can play with if you want. And there we have it. We now have our ultimate flashcard system. So we've got the ability to look at a dictionary, add it to our flashcard system on our phone instantly, and then have that synced to our desktop. And we can look at some cool statistics to see how much we're learning. We can enjoy the benefits of Anki's superior flashcard system. 马到成功.